This video is going to explain how you can use the Is It Fair routine at home to help your students develop number sense. And this, the first few pictures come from Early Childhood Math Routines, which is a book by Antonia Cameron from Stenhouse. And then the end pictures are from Margie Pierce, which I found on Twitter. So when you do this routine, oftentimes it works really well with food. And for very young students, pre-K and K, you might start with two equal amounts. And you could do it with yourself and your child or between two kids in your house and say, I'm going to give you some and I'm going to give you some. Is it fair? And then you have your student respond to whether it's fair or not. And at first they have the very same things and the very same amount, and they can just count and tell you, is it fair or not? So we're working on, are things equal? Did we get the same amount? Then you can switch it up a little bit and still have the same objects and the same amount of objects, but maybe change how they're arranged and see if your student realizes that it's still three things on one side and three things on the other. Even though they are arranged differently, they're still worth the same amount. And so this is fair. And you're getting your student to do the explaining. Next, we might switch to the same number of objects, but maybe change their size. So notice how this time it's pretzel sticks and we have fat pretzel sticks and skinny pretzel sticks. You could even do it with different shaped pretzels and see what they think. At this point, there might be a two right answers, two different ways to think about it, or opinion might be involved. But all of these are things that you can do at the table while you're eating snack. Just have students compare and talk about, is it fair? Which, and then one more. Eventually, you want to show some examples that are not fair and see if they can explain why. Maybe talk about how many more Charlie got than Anna, those kinds of things. So why do we do this routine? It seems very simple. Well, it will help students who are learning to count. Also, it helps students with something called subitizing, which is just a fancy word for recognizing amounts. Like, can you look at three objects and know it's three without counting? Adults do that when we look at the numbers on a dice. We don't have to count each little dot, but we want students to get there as well. Also, this routine is practicing comparing numbers and talking about what's greater and what's less. And those are great words to use as you're doing it. And then it's getting kids to justify, which is backing up their thinking or giving their reasons why they think something. So all of the examples I just explained would be perfect for pre-K and K, maybe first grade too, if you've had the numbers be a little bit larger. But I want to also show you some examples that will work with older students, like third, fourth, and fifth graders. So here's an example that would bring in fractions. You could, break apart cookies or any other thing that would break like this and talk about, do these two kids have the same amount? And sometimes they would say yes, sometimes there are reasons that would say no, but really it's an equivalent amount because over on one side we have 2/4 and on the right-hand side, Aiden has 1/2 and those are actually the same amount. And if we put the fourths together, it would equal the same amount as Aiden. So that'd be a great conversation you could have about fractions. Here's another example. Both of them are equal to 3/4. Just one is broken up into all 3/4, and Shannon's instead is a half and a fourth. A great way to see addition of fractions. And then one more example would be different amounts of different kinds of packaging. You could have your kid justify whether, is one more than the other, maybe do some multiplication to figure out how many grams the Shannon has and how many grams Aiden has altogether. These are just great prompts that you can, as you're moving through your kitchen or the store, notice and talk about whether something is fair or not fair.